Hello everyone, I am Nagaveli Prasad, working in PSWR Center of Excellence, Karimnagar. In the last lesson, we have studied the internal structure of the heart. In that, we have completed atria. Now, today I am going to explain you the structure of ventricles. The lower two chambers of heart known as ventricles, which are thick wall and blood pumping chambers. My dear students, compared to the atria, these are larger in size. And atria receives the blood from the body parts, whereas ventricles pump the blood into the body parts. And ventricles are separated by a septum known as interventricular septum. As interventricular septum, in the same way, interventricular septum. My dear students, the wall of left ventricle is thicker than wall of right ventricle comparatively, because left ventricle sends blood to entire body parts, whereas right ventricle sends blood to only lungs. And when we see the inner surface of each ventricle, so ventricle inner surface has several ridges or elevations or columns like structures. The ridges are called as columnae cornea or trabeculae cornea, my dear students. Whereas we can't find any ridges in the atria, here the inner surface of ventricles has several ridges which are called as columnae cornea or trabeculae cornea. Among these ridges, some are very large and conical. Apart from these, some are large and conical, conical in shape, which are called as papillary muscles. Among those columnae corneae, few are large and conical in shape, which are known as papillary muscles. And this papillary muscle apex is connected to each side of atrioventricular valve. This side tricuspid valve and this side bicuspid valve, you know, to the cusp which are connected. The apex of papillary muscle connected to valve, cusp of valve, called as chordae tendinae or heart strings. My dear students, this will help from bulking too far into the bulking of each cusp into the atrium during systolic ventricular systole. My dear students, I repeat you, when ventricular undergoes systolic pressure, so that the cusp has to close. But if pressure is more, cusp should not go inside the atria, because they are connected with chordae tendinae or heart strings. So this is regarding ventricles. Thank you.
The question for this session is, what are papillary muscles?